I am at Home Depot, my happy place. I'm going to build closets today in the bus. You want to help? Let's go get some wood.
Maximalist Minibus with Mary and Captain and you. Get on the bus!
The key is not to get sidetracked. I'm going to try to pick up everything else I'm going to need for the whole rest of the build, but nothing more. You know, it's just the stuff I need. No matter how cute some of those tools are, not going to buy them. Nope, not even going to look at them. All right. Well, I was able to pick up a lot of the things on my list, but not everything. I have what I need to do the walls, and that was my main goal for today. So the good thing about having so many things on my list is that I didn't really have the energy or the time to browse. Because me browsing in Home Depot, I tend to get kind of lost in there and end up with things that are just like, no, but I needed it. I really did. Because, I mean, a lot of times I do need it. A lot of times I don't. I am amazed, though, at how expensive lumber has gotten. It's crazy. I just bought one sheet of 3/4-inch birch plywood, and it was $59. So last time I bought that, it was like maybe $32, I think. This street is always going to be a nightmare to drive on. The bus itself makes a lot of squeaks, like the body of the bus. And I didn't really realize that because there was so much inside the bus that was making noise that I wasn't really hearing all the squeakities of the actual physical bus itself. But now I am. I had the cutter guy cut my sheets of plywood into two pieces that are 20 inches by 74 5/8 inches. That's the height of the side of the wall that's toward the middle. And of course, there's the curve going into the wall. So I have to cut the top of the plywood to fit into the curve. I'm not going to worry about the sides because it's too complicated. That's just a recipe for frustration and disaster. It's going to be a little tricky to show you what I'm doing because I don't want to show you too much of the bus because I'm really looking forward to having like a big reveal. So I'm going to start off. I'm going to use this newsprint to make a pattern. It's really flexible and I can really jam it into the curve. So then once I have that paper version, I'm going to lay that down on cardboard and cut out of cardboard a pattern. Then I'm going to take that pattern and hold it to the wall and make sure it works. And in this particular case, there's a copper pipe up here. There's a channel here along the wall that holds all the electrical, and I need to cut a notch for that. Last time I did this, it was the first time I had ever used a jigsaw. So, and that was when I did the cabinets. So I only had to cut small curves, and I had a hard time with that. Here goes. I'm going to cut on this line all the way out. Then I'm going to cut this notch, and then I'm going to come back and cut this. And of course I accidentally had the rear camera on while I was actually cutting. Okay, I guess I need to cut that again. I had to cut a hole. I got to use my hole dozer, but I had to cut a hole so that the copper pipe could go through here. Because I'm not going to take the pipe down. I need the curtains. And yeah, it's not really an obstruction in the closet. So I'm just going to let it be. I'm going to apply contact paper. I'm using this little squeegee thing to do this. With this, you can push out bubbles and stuff. And it's not going to be perfect because nothing I do is ever perfect. But it's at least going to be flatter than it would be if I didn't use the squeegee. These rivets here, I thought they were showing me where the support beam in the ceiling and the wall was, but they are not. There are rivets that run across the bus on the beams, and then there are rivets that hold the sheet metal onto the ceiling, and that's what these are doing. So there's really no strength in this top piece. I'm still going to put an L bracket there because it provides support, but I'm going to attach it to the floor, and then on this side, there's this very substantial, rigid piece going down the side that I can use to bolt into. Okay, so that's done, and it's not perfect, like I said, but what is? I wish that the pieces were a little bit longer, but I guess that's 20 inches, because that's what I asked for. So now we're going to do the other side. The other side's a little more complicated because it doesn't have that solid piece for me to bolt into, for one thing. The bed will be right up against that wall. The closet on the other side is 10 inches. This side is going to be 12 inches. I have a couple extra inches on this side because the other side has the door.
I'm not going to say I screwed up. I'm just going to say I take things that I should be questioning at face value, and then I question things that I should probably trust. First of all, I did the measurement for the other side the same way you saw me do the last one. That is, I used the paper, then I copied that onto cardboard, then I cut the cardboard, then I put that on the wood. But I said to myself somewhere in there, this can't possibly be right. It looks, the curve is too curvy, so I adjusted it by eyeball. So I don't trust a template that I made by measuring and coming in contact with the actual curve. But I trust myself to judge the curve by eyeball. Obviously, I had a lot harder time getting that one to work. I had to recut it a bunch of times. It's not as lovely as I would have liked, but I did get it to work. And then once I had both of the walls up and I was finishing up last night, they definitely did not look the same size. And it's not because of how I cut it. I didn't alter the width at all. But the guy in the lumber department who cut the wood for me, he gave me one piece that's just shy of 20 inches and one that's just shy of 19 inches. So yeah, they're wrong, and they're wrong different from each other. So you see what I'm saying? I should have measured the Home Depot cuts, because now there's nothing I can do about it. It's still better than what I would have done with my jigsaw, but I do have to find a solution to it this morning. And I have to find it quick because it's about to rain, and I won't be able to cut wood in the driveway once that starts. So if my solution involves any cutting, I'll be out of luck because my canopy is in Warren where I'm doing the rebuild. Because that's one of the things that's going to go in this closet. I have an idea though, and it involves a return trip to Home Depot. No cutting this time. Wish me luck. So here is the final product. This stuff is finished to look like barnwood, and I'm not normally into the fakey fakey thing, but it was a quick solution and I needed a quick solution, and I think it actually looks pretty good. It made both sides, both closets, a little bit sturdier, and by positioning that framing wood straight up, I was able to make them look more like they're the same size. And of course they looked a little slanted because of the curve of the bus, but by putting the wood straight, I put it straight relative to the door, and that kind of creates the illusion that they're straight. This side, I'm going to keep all my tall things in their canopies I use for swap meets, awning poles, not the awning itself, because that compresses small enough to fit in a cabinet, but the poles. This side is going to be shelves, and the shelves are going to be the slide out, the pull out kind, so that I can get better access to the stuff that's in there. That's the plan anyway. The one on the driver's side, that one will have the bed up against it, but there's a gap showing. It doesn't have that yellow piece that goes vertically down the side. But I know how I'm gonna fix it. I can't show you right now though. That's for the big reveal. Look, I just wanna be clear too that I could edit out all the dumb things I do. I leave them in because maybe if you see me do it, you won't do it. And
the truth is they're not actually dumb things. They're just part of a learning curve.
Not to be mistaken for a wall curve. I'm rounding the corner on the rebuild, so I should be able to show you something soon, fairly soon. If you're not caught up, maybe watch this. That'll catch you up. I'll see you there.